Welcome to the government's video about the Stability Treaty. We've got some nice diagrams coming up here. Look, there's us, Ireland. And with all the other countries that use the euro, we're completely fucked. Though the government wants to turn this into a conversation about strong rules. Because when they do, they can get away with not talking about the growing poverty and inequality or the massive unemployment and immigration and the general tax on the most weakest and vulnerable in our society that just shows this is an ongoing and repeat of the same economic crisis. They want to talk about strong rules and regulations that have pictures of locks. Because when they do that, they can get away with not talking about the fact that there is no stable euro, that there ain't no economic growth, there's no investment and jobs have gone up to Swanee. It's okay to talk about a strong, stable currency, but when you're a small island state that's given up that power long ago, we actually don't have any control over that whatsoever. So here's the deal. We can't return to the money markets because successive governments continue this socialisation of the private debt of banks that forces me and you to pay it back for the rest of our lives. So we're going to be forced to get what's called a second bailout, even though it isn't really a bailout, it's more of a stitch-up. In the treaty they say unless you pass it, you won't get this bailout. This isn't true, there are other ways of getting the money. And I mean, they already said that most of the laws here are the same. But this government in Iraq just will continue to do exactly what Fianna Fáil did, which is set taxes to suit the rich and decide how to spend your money as you get poorer. You have been asked to decide to vote on whether to ratify this treaty. Is it an important one for you and your future? That's up for you to decide. But you'd be fucking stupid to vote yes for this stability treaty.